Hello, 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 my loves. How are you all doing? So to begin off this eye look today, I'm going in with my MAC Soft Ochre Paint Pot. Of course, it's my classic go-to. I love this so much. It's my ride or die. I'm applying it with an Eggsho large crease brush all over the lid and up toward the brow bone. I want to neutralize that whole eyelid area so that there's no veins or redness showing through, and it allows the eyeshadows to show up really pigmented and true to color. I'm also going to go in with some tape just to kind of line up the eye look. I do want a really crisp, sharp line, so the tape is going to allow me to get that. And for the eyeshadow that I'm going in with today is Poolside. First of all, it's a Makeup Geek eyeshadow, and I'm going in on a fluffy crease brush from Zoeva. I'm applying that right up against that tape first of all to make sure it's nice and pigmented and really sharp. I want to create a really sharp line, and as you can see, I'm blowing it out quite far past the brow. And I'm also bringing it back through the crease, just the outer crease area. As you guys can see, I'm keeping it very focused on the outer V. Then I'm going in with a lighter blue shadow on a fluffy crease brush from Zoeva. This is the 227 crease brush. And I'm applying that just above Poolside. So Poolside is more of a satin shade. It's not a matte, it's more satiny. However, this light blue shade is a matte blue. And it's a couple shades lighter than Poolside, so it's going to create a nice soft smoky blend. Next, I'm going in on a pencil brush with Sapphire. It's a stunning, stunning, really deep royal, I guess the name says it all, the Sapphire Blue. I'm applying this along that tape and through the outer crease area, making sure to create a nice sharp line along that tape because I do want to create that nice sharp, crisp line. Then I go back through the outer crease area, keeping it just under Poolside because I do want to create a nice soft gradient. And as you can see, I'm kind of creating a smoky wing effect on the outer corner of my eye, just near those lashes. Not all the way through to the inner corner, just keeping it focused on the outer third of the eye. Then I'm going back in with that fluffy crease brush and some of Poolside, and I'm going in and buffing out Sapphire, just so it's nice and smoky and there's no harsh lines. I'm also going back in with some of that light blue shade from the Chi Chi palette and just softening Poolside as well. So it's all seamless and there's no harsh lines, just how I like it. Okay, next is the red part of this Independence Day look. So I'm going in with a petite crease brush from Zoeva and some of this like peachy reddy shade from the Chi Chi Pride palette. I'm going in and applying that just on like that inner socket area, as you guys can see, right where that brow is, just keeping it underneath. I begin off not buffing it through my brows, but as you'll see later on, I actually do bring this shadow right through the like front, the head of my brow kind of area. And I'm not bringing it through to the blue. I'm actually stopping it about halfway across the eye socket area just because I don't want it to actually go through to the blue. I want them to remain separate. Next, I'm taking this beautiful crimson red shade. I'm going in on the same petite crease brush and just deepening up the red. Then I'm taking this beautiful burgundy red shade on a pencil brush from Zoeva and I'm just deepening up that red tone area and just buffing it along toward the brow bone, not on the brow bone but just toward it, if you guys can see what I mean. And I do go back and forth again with those shadows to blend them out so that there's no harsh lines, and you guys can see I am bringing it through to the head of my brow, keeping it kind of along that nose area, not on the nose. I just want to keep it in that kind of socket area. Alrighty, Roo, next we're going to cut that kind of crease area just where the red is. I'm not touching the blue area, I'm literally just kind of crisping and cleaning up the bottom of the red, so when we apply the eyeliner next, it's more crisp and clean and there's no like red seeping onto the lid. As you guys can see, I'm going in with this beautiful, like very vibrant, shimmery blue liquid eyeliner. This is, I think this is called Shook or something. I'll leave a link down below, I can't quite remember what the name is. But it's from Revlon. It's a beautiful liquid liner. And as you guys can see, I'm actually going along that cut crease on the first third of my eye, just kind of following that line we've created with the cut crease, and then going up along the red and connecting it to my brow. Sorry, it's hard to explain it. I hope you guys can kind of see what I mean. However, guys, what I've done later on, I actually don't keep that kind of triangle area where the red is. I actually get rid of that and just kind of create more of like a half cut crease per se. So maybe watch this whole tutorial through before following along if you are going to follow along, because I do change the whole eyeliner shape in general. So I chop and change a little bit here. I actually wanted to apply a eyeshadow to my lid area. I just thought it was a bit bare with just like, you know, the paint pot and everything. So I went in with WA, which is a beautiful kind of shimmery white eyeshadow, and I applied that all over that kind of blank space before the blue, just on the inner third of the eye, and also highlighted my inner corners with that as well. Then I go back in with that liquid liner again from Revlon, and I just go and connect the cut crease to the kind of eyelid area, as you guys can just see here. And when I did that, I was like, oh, it looks a little bit too much like a clown, like a like clown eye look. So I do change it a little bit later on, but I go in with some stars first. I was just kind of trialing and erroring. I think that makes sense with this look. So I do kind of go back and forth. Sorry. Anyway, I'm going in with three stars along that nice kind of smoky wing outer corner area, just to kind of mimic the American flag for all you beautiful Americans out there. And then I go in and apply it to like along that red part as well. And I go in with some of this beautiful holographic glitter and just kind of spice up those stars a little bit and put a few little bits of glitter next to them, just to make them a little bit more shimmery and show up a bit more pigmented. So just moving on, as you guys can see, I actually end up taking away those stars on the red area and going in with glitters from that holographic container that I showed you before. This glitter is not eye safe, so please proceed with caution if you guys do choose to use it. Otherwise, there's many safe eye glitters out there for you guys to get your hands on and use those instead. And I went in with this kind of shimmery burgundy shade to connect the red into the brow bone highlight, which is WA from the Focalure palette that I used on my inner corners. For lashes, I went in with the Attitude Lashes in the style Feisty. And as you guys can see, I did fix up that eyeliner. Okay, now we're moving on to the bottom lash line. I go in with Ocean Green from BYS. It's a kind of like a greeny blue eye kohl. Then I go in and set that eye kohl because it's not really that pigmented. It doesn't show up that much, so I actually wanted to make it a little bit more vibrant. I went in with Pegasus, which is a single foiled eyeshadow from Makeup Geek, and it's so vibrant and so stunning. And I just applied that along my waterline. If you guys have sensitive eyes, please don't use like an eyeshadow in your waterline. It'll really aggravate them. Just use an eye kohl instead or a gel liner. Alrighty, Roo. Next, I'm going to smoke out my bottom lash line. So I'm going to take Sapphire on a precise shader brush from Zoeva. I'm just smoking out the outer third of my eye. Then I'm going in with some of this black eyeshadow from the Jaclyn Hill Morphe palette. And I'm really wiggling that quite tight along my bottom lash line. I wanted it to be a little bit more darker and smokier compared to the top. And I'm just smoking out those shadows with some of Poolside from Makeup Geek. I go in with some of that red shade to smoke it out even further and bring more of those red tones into the bottom lash line. However, I do regret that decision. I think it looked better with just the blue and not putting the red there. It just made me look quite tired and sick, as you guys can see. Like, I don't really like the effect of the red. So if you guys are recreating this look, best to just use the blue, not the red. And then I use some of this beautiful kind of electric blue mascara from Rimmel, and I just coat my bottom lashes with that. And this, guys, concludes today's eye makeup look for the 4th of July. I really hope you guys enjoyed it. It is a bit higgledy-piggledy, I am sorry, but we did get there in the end, so that's the main thing. I hope you guys did enjoy this look. If you did, please leave a big thumbs up and let me know what you'd like to see next down below. I love you all so, so much. Thank you for your endless support, and I'll see you very, very soon. Mwah. Bye.